things.
Why presenting one? Before you start presenting one,
So, according to the DSM-4 criteria of diagnostic of post-traumatic stress disorder, you find that there is avoidance of the same environment. Why you find the victim avoids anything that is the arousal of memories and is the occurrence of the event, like the place, activity, and sport. So, it may be based on that. So, if you ask why I say based on this, maybe avoidance of the person who actually abused them, if it's sexual abuse, and if it's an activity that is the occurrence of the and if you look at the sports overview, that would be another activity. So this is actually marked with marked declaration of arousal and reaction. So you find hypervigilance, you find you also find unrecovered ones, you also find low concentration and so the next one that should require is the association of social reactions. When you find the victim was, for example, the victim was hurt, you try to dissociate from male friends or male relatives. So they feel like they will be harmed in the same way that the event transpired. So we have we find that another sign and symptom of post-traumatic disorder, we find that you have physiological distress or reactions. Why we find that the victim has experiences that he can't become into contact with anything that leads to the arousal of memories of things. Like any case of any male who comes into contact with
him, it's raining.
So you find that you try to avoid them. And another one that you find also is concurrent related to particular nightmares. So this is where you find the victim has nightmares due to the intrusive memories and flashbacks. So this is where you find hallucinations. Now, hallucinations are only two types of problems. General somatic hallucinations, where you find a person feels that someone is going to be there, and now say it's worse to run from the house. So they feel like there's a meal.
So, let me just stop it. Excuse me, hey, don't allow anyone to go. One person at a time, disturbing us. Those are coming in, I don't know whether you're allowing them or the same. Because honestly, those of you at the door are in, you allow anyone to come in. You need to have a moment. So you have to touch that is
yeah, so talking of recurrent related post-traumatic nightmares. Here you find the person experiences hallucinations. Now hallucinations that are called the post-traumatic disorder mostly are the two types of hallucinations. These tactile hallucinations and general somatic hallucinations. So I say general somatic hallucinations, these are the type of hallucinations where a person feels that there's someone close to them who wants to harm them. Then if you look at tactile, so tactile simply means touch. So tactile means they seem to have a feeling of someone just touching you. So other signs and symptoms is resistant inactivity and inability to have positive vibes of the transpired.